Welcome to each of our witnesses today. My staff and I have heard from pediatricians from across the country, including right in Delaware and Moore's Children's Hospital, fabled Children's Hospital that we're very proud of. And we hear from any number of sources that our country is experiencing a mental health crisis among children and youth. And I don't think it's just in Delaware, I think it's throughout our country. But during the pandemic, children have experienced major disruptions as a result of public health safety measures, including school closures, social isolation, financial hardships, and gaps in healthcare access. It's become clear that COVID-19 has significantly exacerbated the health stress on children and youth, highlighting our nation's acute shortage of mental health services and the need to reinforce and expand the pediatric mental health delivery systems and infrastructure. Question for Dr. Durham, if I could. Dr. Durham, what more can those of us in the Congress do to address root causes and support effective approaches to prevention and early identification of mental and behavioral health issues? Dr. Durham.
Thank you very much for that question. As you mentioned, many of our kids experience a lot of loss. And when we think of loss, it's not only death in their within their family, but also thinking of not being able to see their friends or do the social activities and other things that fulfill a livelihood. I do think one thing that we need to think from a prevention promotion standpoint is that many of our schools, even in the Boston area, don't have school therapists that they have access to. So when we think, we don't want people to always get treatment with their severe level of illness, that they need to be in a hospital or an emergency room. And how can we start thinking in a prevention and promotion framework of just touches, if you will. So meaning something's going on, a teacher notes it, a principal or someone in the school or the family, and that they have the services right there within the school system before we get to the point where you're calling the emergency services or a crisis line. There are not enough supports within the school system to do any of that sort of prevention and promotion framework. Teachers are doing a lot. They're doing their job, but we don't have therapists that are even embedded in many of our schools, even when we think about a resource-rich place like Massachusetts. And so I think it is critical that we think about it in that framework. I do think pediatric integrated care is another way to think more about prevention and promotion. So seeing children and families at their well child visits, which we do in Massachusetts, and start thinking and asking those questions about what stressors are happening in their lives and getting care for immediate needs, whether it's a mild, you know, behavioral health need, depression or anxiety that isn't to the point where maybe they're thinking about harming themselves or harming anyone else. So using that framework of prevention and promotion, I think, is critical. And sometimes that is not necessarily reimbursed from a mental health standpoint as it is for physical health, that kids are supposed to go get their visits quite early in life for a check-in. And the more we can think about even like a mental health check-in with their primary care provider or therapist in the school, I think the better we would all be in the long run.
Yeah, thanks. A question for the record, if I could, for all of our witnesses. Several months ago, I was in the Bay Area in California and visiting a number of promising technology companies. One was called Ginger, G-I-N-G-E-R, in the Bay Area. And they focused on coverage for, they focused on mental health screenings and behavioral health coaching. And I have a question regarding the coverage for those screenings and coaching. And I would just ask if any of our witnesses, if any of you find virtual behavioral health coaching to be an efficient means of preventing serious mental illness, and if so, should Congress consider mandating coverage for virtual mental health screenings and behavioral health coaching in plans offered on the health insurance marketplace? That's a question for the record for each of you. Thank you very much. Thank you.